Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to copy a line segment, like the one here. You're probably thinking that you just measure how long it is with a ruler and redraw it, right? Well, what if I tell you that this is one of those concepts that was around before rulers? Can you do it without a ruler? By the end of this lesson, you should be able to use a compass and straight edge to copy a line segment. First, I'll show you some tips that'll help you get used to using a compass. Then, you'll learn how to copy a line segment using a compass and straight edge rather than a ruler. So, tuck that ruler away from this lesson, like far, far away. Maybe even on the other side of your house so you're not tempted to use it. Also, there are some steps that you'll need to follow as you go through this video, so remember to pause the video anytime you need to. Now, we've never had to draw using a geometric compass before, so let's go over some tips and tricks to make this a smooth learning experience. First, when you're putting your pencil into your compass, make sure that the tip of the pencil and the tip of the compass line up with each other. This is to ensure that you've set the pencil at the right length to make drawing a circle possible. Next, in order to set the distance between the tip of the compass and the tip of the pencil that you want, you need to tighten the screws and rods you'll find at the hinge of the compass. Different compasses have different screws and rods, so get comfortable with what your compass has. As for the exact distance you're using right now, it doesn't really matter, but something like 2 inches should be plenty. Also, make sure that those screws and rods are nice and tight. You do not want the compass to change its distance while you're trying to draw with it. Next, practice holding your compass like this so that it's easy to rotate with your fingers. If your compass doesn't hold its setting very well, you may need to play around with holding it a little further down or even holding it like you would hold a pencil. Whenever you're creating a construction or a drawing with a compass, you should always put more pressure on the side where the compass tip meets the paper and not on the side where the pencil tip meets the paper. When we're drawing with it, the compass tip won't move. Only the pencil tip will. Here's a fun tip. Some people actually prefer to rotate the paper instead of the compass. I recommend you try it both ways and see whichever method works best for you. Getting really good with drawing things with a compass takes a lot of time and practice. So, we've made a special space for it in your notes template, where you can take some time now to practice drawing circles. If your notes template is stapled together, it may be easier to go off and get your own piece of paper for practice. So, why don't you pause the video now and take as much time as you need to perfect those compass skills. Now that you're comfortable using your compass, let's learn how to copy a line segment. These directions say to copy segment LM and label it segment ST. Copying a line segment involves making a new segment that's the same length as the original. First, use your straight edge to draw a line segment. Make sure the line segment looks longer than segment LM. Since our new segment will be called segment ST, place point S at one end of the segment. Then, adjust your compass setting so the distance between the tip of the compass and the tip of the pencil matches the distance between points L and M. Be sure to tighten the setting on your compass so the distance between the compass tip and the pencil tip doesn't change when moving the compass. Move the compass so its tip is on point S and draw part of a circle, also known as an arc, that intersects the segment. You could draw an entire circle here using the compass, but that's really not necessary because we only need a small arc. Sometimes, if you're using an online compass, it will require you to make an entire circle and not just an arc. This can make your construction look cluttered, so we try to avoid it when we can. Place point T where the arc you just drew meets up with the line segment. If you'd like to lightly erase the excess line segment that didn't get used and the arc, you certainly can, but it's best not to completely erase these markings because they are good evidence that we used a compass and straight edge to make our construction. We can now say that line segment LM is congruent to segment ST. The symbol here means congruent or identical to. There are many other correct ways to write that these line segments are congruent, but I'm going to stay with the way it was phrased in the original directions. It doesn't say in the directions that we have to write this congruence statement, but when we do write it, we verify to anyone looking at our drawing that we made sure segment ST is identical to segment LM. Let's do one more example. This time we're going to construct a segment 4 times the length of segment AB and label it segment CD. First, use your straight edge to draw a line segment. Make sure the line segment looks at least 4 times longer than segment AB. Since our new segment will be called segment CD, place point C at one end of the segment. Then, adjust your compass setting so the distance between the tip of the compass and the tip of the pencil matches the distance between points A and B. Be sure to tighten the setting on your compass so the compass setting doesn't accidentally get changed. Move the compass so its tip is on point C and draw an arc that intersects the segment. Repeat this process 3 more times for a total of 4 arcs. Remember, you can draw entire circles with your compass, but it'll add unnecessary clutter. So small arcs are the best. Place point D where your final arc meets up with the line segment. Go ahead and lightly erase the excess line segment that didn't get used, and the arcs if you want to, but it's best not to completely erase these markings because they're a good reminder that we used a compass and straight edge to make this. In the previous problem, we were able to write a congruence statement to verify that the segment we constructed was congruent to the original. Can we do the same thing here? No, we'll not be able to write a congruence statement because segment CD is not congruent to segment AB. It's 4 times longer. Now you can copy line segments, and you've gotten pretty good at using a compass. You'll need to be able to draw all sorts of things with your compass in this course, so get all the practice you can in now. This way, you'll be super confident using your compass later. Your next step is to complete the line segment design activity. It's on the next page in your notes template. Have fun making your design, and I'll see you next time.